Thursday, February 18th, and we're gonna jump into announcements, which are about a new form of taking customs license broker exam. So the customs a couple of days ago made an announcement that there will be a remote proctored exam delivery option available. This is the first time this has been done, and this is something which you guys need to be aware of and weigh pros and cons. So let's go over the stuff that I think are relevant, because I believe they say this stuff comes on first serve, first accept basis, but customs do not specify how, when, and where they are doing this. They simply say if you're interested in remote proctoring, go through the systems check, and do this at various times of days, and to make sure your connection is good. So what that's supposed to mean? Also, let me drop this link. You guys should have that link saved as your favorites, but let me drop this link off, so that way we're all on the same page. So basically, what's going on here? So you everything is pretty much still, they say, is going to be the same. The only difference is there will be your computer, and your computer is in a way your fortress. In other words, if your computer fails, then you are responsible for all the misdeeds. So that's pretty much the way it is. It goes through the steps, and most important is if you decide to go for it and take it home, or wherever, as customs examiners say, four walls are available, you need to be mindful that you cannot switch. And I guess you have to be able to when I registered for my exam, I remember I registered for the location in Seattle, but then I had to move to Miami, and I made a switch to Miami without any issues. Of course, back then it was all paper driven. So the major difference between take home do it at home and do it at the site, to me it seems that you're allowed to have your phone. So you can have your smartphone device, and that will be your kind of like your lifeline to whatever is going on. Okay. So everyone, hello. So for those of you that are just joining, I am talking about the message that came out a couple of days ago by CBP, where they say, because of coronavirus and 21st century and technological advantages, they are giving option of take the CBP exam at home as opposed to going to location. All right. So pretty much the link that I provide, the procedure is there. So number one, you're going to register. Registration is just a few days away. It's on 22nd. So recall my email about the President's Day, the Washington's birthday, that it falls on 22nd. Yes, well, it can be at home, or it can be anywhere of your apparently at the location of your choice, as long as you have a robust internet connection. So that's the idea. So let me just go over some highlights. So the procedure, according to the CBP, you have to register. So between now, let's say 18th and 22nd, you go on the link and check whether your system is compatible. So they talk about the software, they talk about the firewall, they talk about the internet connection and all that stuff. So once that is done, you by 22nd you have to have pretty good idea of whether your system is compatible or not. If your system is compatible and it looks good, then you send, after registration, you get the confirmation number by email. You use that confirmation number, and then you go according to the directions. There is an email, and with that email, you go and notify of your willingness to go and take the customs broker license exam remotely. Home, office, wherever. So here, let me see if they have the, yeah, right there. So send the email to these guys after you register, provided that your system requirements are met. They will notify you if you're good or you're not good. And once they notify you that, suppose you went through, you were approved, you were accepted, then you become what I should say the first, I shouldn't use the term lab rat, but you'll be the first experiencer of this type of the exam. So then on the day of the exam, you seal yourself off in a room where only you are available. And once you seal yourself in that room, you have a camera, and the camera is the point of communication and window between what they call a proctor and yourself. So apparently the ID making process, we're gonna observe a short video that they posted, but the verification process, I guess you pull out your IDs and you just show it to the cam, like here's my IDs. And they say, okay, fine, you pass as long as the IDs are valid. And after that, they going to say, well, you should start it. All right. And you have to go through a bunch of other requirements, such as, well, for one, there will be something called, well, I don't know if they if the software will lock out your computer, but I think they ask your word that you all will only be using the link that they provide and all that stuff. So let me explain. Let me get. I'll tell you what I think about it. Just let me go through the steps, and then go and tell you about my experience, because I was a lab rat when I took my New Jersey bar, and with the computers and all that stuff. And at the same time, I took New York bar. The bar is like the example where was in an old school way. So I'll share it with you in a second. But let me just finish this one first. So basically, you seal yourself up. You seal yourself up in a room. Provided all is good, you going to start the exam. And you're allowed 2 bathroom breaks. Once you go to the bathroom break, I'm not sure how the procedure is. I guess you can step out and step back in. How the permission asking process, I guess the proctor will always be staring at you through the webcam, and those guys will be like, whoever just joined, hello, I'm talking about the examination, which is available to do home, CBLE. Customs just released that a couple of days ago, and we're just going through the details right now. So anyway, back to the situation. So now the question comes up, whether you should do that or whether you should not do that. So the answer is twofold. So it's not a secret for everyone. We have this nasty virus on our hand. I personally had friends and colleagues who went through the misery of having a coronavirus in a very nasty form. Some people are at heightened risk, and some people are just they have immunity or heightened risk. I'm talking about the age, right, and pre-existing conditions. So of course, going out, every time you go out, is you get a re you get a risk of infection. I know that everyone is getting vaccinated now. I do not know how the process goes. I know that my friends from the healthcare sector, they had that option. Some took it, some didn't, for various reasons. Someone Well, some people outside of the healthcare sector, they're still waiting. So I do not know about the vaccine and all that other stuff. But my view is this: if you are one of those individuals who are at risk, and the cost of you contracting the coronavirus, the possibility is just is higher than for many other people, let's put it this way, then this option is something which you should highly consider. So Abby, you have, I guess, 2 doses. That's the one of those Pfizer ones, right? Okay, so suppose you either have antibodies because you went through this, you got antibodies because you've been vaccinated, and you are not afraid to be around people. Because listen, this stuff drives many people crazy. So that, on top of the anxiety you're gonna go through, this is a part of the equation. So if I was in that risk category, I would probably consider the option of taking it remotely by internet. However, what's the problem with that? Well, we know the history of electronic examination itself, when customs first rolled it out, it was accompanied by a lot of technical issues. There were hang-ups on the system, meaning that the screen froze. There were issues with being able to submit things. Some people complained that even the results that they've been submitting do not correspond to the results that customs says the system received. So it's just like with many IT issues. You had specialized IT people who were dedicated to this full time, and they still couldn't foresee many problems that did come up. You can imagine just last exam, the October one. So customs released the notice, and they had to say, okay, we had again and again we experienced the system issues. And I think I talked about it during the first day of class, where customs kind of considered it, and they said, well, we don't think it was harsh enough to have a meaningful impact, so we're just gonna let it slide. So imagine while you are having to manage your own hardware, if something happens, all this time you sit and prepare for the exam, this is something which, and if some technical issue happens on your end, you'll be at fault in a way. You accept it's not your fault. Well, it's kind of like assumption of the risk, right? And let me tell you, I was attending that webinar for CBP protests. It's online now. If you guys wanna interested in, well, we didn't get to the protest yet, but I'll have you, once we get to the protest chapter, I'll have you watch that webinar as well. So pretty much, or maybe not the, maybe it was a symposium one. So basically, there was this gentleman. He was a CBP director of some either center or some office, and he was in the middle of presentation while his computer restarted. So all of a sudden, everything went dark, and he went blank. So, and that's the individual with experience and help of direct help of U.S. Customs. When going back to my experience, so I took my bar exam in two states, in New Jersey and New York, and New York was old school way, so you come in and it was a piece of paper and all that other stuff. Everything went fine. So New Jersey implemented the electronic version where you bring your laptop, you download the software, and the software locks out all the other stuff. So yes, you did the testing just like customs is asking you to test your own system, your own equipment that you will be planning to use. And they say, all right, so I brought my laptop, I showed up to the exam site, which was in a hotel, and because it was the first time, I mean, I tested a number of times, everything was supposed to be fine, but guess what? There was not enough power supplies in the testing room, or rather the hallway, right? Well, testing hall, right? It was one of those big meeting rooms in a hotel. So one of the proctors had to run to Home Depot and buy those power supplies so that people could take the exam. And this is minor, but obviously this is something that could be could be taken care of. Now imagine yourself if you're an examinee. You're just sitting there, you're anxious, you want to get this over with. You've probably been studying, pulling all-nighters, and you just want to do this and get it over with, right? And instead, they make you sit for hours waiting for someone to get the power surges. And then you're crumbled in one room. The desks are small. That waiting while you are very tired, you're very anxious, is not very helpful. It's easier just to get in, do your thing, and get out. So that's my view on this. If you can, and you are not being, because of your health or other conditions, age or whatever it is, you do not feel comfortable stepping out, then this is something to do for you. If otherwise, you are taking a huge risk of many things that can go wrong. And if there is something that can go wrong, it probably will go wrong. So I would rather not be a lab rat in this situation. I would rather go to the site. Yes, they still have issues with the site, but at least you're not a pioneer, if you will, of this experimentation. Because this is important stuff. You are studying for this. You are taking your time to come to this class. You invested. So you have enough things to worry about. And then there's some kind of technology fails you, and it's on you. Come on, this is not fun, to say it lightly. So that's my view on this. But other than that, what would be the advantages? So according to this CBP notice, right? It will be all pretty much be the same, with the only difference you will be allowed to access the cell phone, smartphone, right? So here it is. As stated above, phones, including cell phones, must be located out on the arm's reach during the customs broker license exam. We're talking about the remote one. The only approved usage is to communicate with a proctor if there is an internet disconnection. So that's about the only difference. However, they say you have to be in a room by yourself. So it means it can be like one of those IKEA wall dividers, right, where there is someone on the other side. It has to be empty room with four walls. I think this is the way they described it in the notice. But those walls are something which, for example, when I was studying for my bar exam, I had one corner in the room. Just like, remember, I asked you to do those reviews. So you can become a librarian. You will have an easy time to recall all this stuff, and you'll be able to kind of come in and without wasting your time answer any question, simply because you can retrieve it through your memory just like that. Now with the walls, what I've done, some people use flashcards, but I kind of like taped to the wall. So for example, I had a criminal law corner, so I had all those criminal law stuff, which will come up or may come up on the exam. Then I had a family law corner. Then I had the constitutional law corner. I had the the civil stuff, the contracts, for example, had administrative law corner. So all those corners, in the morning, I would make myself coffee and I would go through all of them around, and this way I kind of learned how to become a librarian, because by the time I showed up at the bar exam, I kind of had to imagine myself in that room. Yes, so I remember that question because I was doing the review on that particular case, and I can ask, I can answer it relatively easy. So imagine yourself, you are being in your own room. Now recall, proctors are limiting, if you show up to the site, they're limiting your stuff to whatever you can put in that case. I was kind of being ironic about it because there were some contradictory messages, and simply because some of the stuff you can't fit within what you're allowed to have volume wise. And that caddy that they talked about by itself exceeds the volume of what they say is allowed. But basically, it's an open book exam and you can bring a lot of stuff. Imagine if you're in your own room. Now, you can create, let's say, power of attorney corner. You can create the protest corner. You can create the entry corner. You can have a classification corner. And you can have all that stuff that you find important right there. So I'm not sure if they will let you get up. I know they will let you have bathroom breaks. But this is something you can cover you all up. And this is the advantage of which I'm thinking, as opposed to bringing your stuff to the foreign environment. You're in your own environment. But so this is, and they don't put I went through this advisory notice, and they don't seem to be putting any of the restrictions, like you all have to be in a certain way, like you can't have any information on it or whatever. So it just says you can't use electronic stuff. So you can't Google things, or you can't PDF stuff. The only thing is you can have that approved communication one way with CBP proctors. So that's one advantage I see. But I think because this is the first time stuff, I think that advantage is greatly outweighed by disadvantage, which is possibility of something that can go wrong. So that's my view on it. I said what I think, and if you can, and you are not like psychologically and physically, I'm not putting yourself in too much of a harm's way, I'd say just go to the site. Because this is first time, and let other people handle the situation, which with whatever it is. Having said that, between now and the next time we meet, which is next week, there will be registration. So registration starts on February 22nd, so we are 4 days away. You will be required to create your own account. It's pretty easy, just like creating any other account. Then you'll be prompted to register, you'll be prompted to make a payment. And payment, I just did my payment for my triennial, which is requirement where every licensed custom broker is required to submit that they did not deviate from good moral character requirements, and whatever they've been doing for the past 3 years, where they live, etc., etc. So I submitted the payment by PayPal. Everything worked fine. So got the confirmation by email, print screen, all that stuff. So no issues there. All right, so I think I said what I wanted to say about all this stuff. The only thing that I wanna, I guess, well, think we can play this. You know what? I'm not gonna waste too much time on this because this is well, how long is it? It's 4 minutes. So instead, I'm going to drop down the link. Okay. Once, please save that link. So this is a link about the like if you going to take it home in the office or wherever, this is kind of like a sneak preview of how they're gonna test your IDs, how there will be the broker looking at you all the time. So it's just a quick instructional video about how things gonna go if you're gonna take it at home or wherever remotely. So yeah. All right, so that's for the announcements.